Yo, what's up, everybody? I'm just here taking a stroll through our newly upgraded exterior of our farming town in our survival world. I've done even more work outside since last episode. Welcome, by the way, to episode 40, I hope. Haven't done anything that way. Let's not go that way. I've added some trees. I had a tree there. That's not so pretty from this side. I think that one's gonna have to have some touching up. I brought this trail out here and connected it there. That didn't connect before. Added this tree, which is huge. I did a little thing. Somebody left a comment saying to do what I was doing with the trees, but on a pile of dirt too high, and it'll let you use, it'll give you more room to make a bigger trunk, and that's exactly what I did. It looks pretty good. Kind of gives you two different looks. This is more of an, this is more of a looming over you kind of tree, right? And this one's like, you walk, if it feels nice and enclosed when you walk under it. So, depends on what you're going for, you get different things. Anyway, I've done quite a bit of stuff. Actually, the majority of the building that is in this episode is already done, so we're just gonna talk about what I've done, my thought process behind it. You know how we like to do, get really into building theory and stuff and discuss it. So before we, this right here was not here, this wall and the ceiling, this roof did not extend all the way. I went ahead and my inventory is a mess. I am very aware. Let's get up here and look around, knock that down because I do not want that. Don't want a dirty roof. I've done the roof. It is, except for right here, I'm not sure if I'm just going to have this go whoop or if it'll go back and then down. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with this peak right here. So this is clear. Ooh, you can see some more stuff that I did there. So that leaves the only stuff left for the exterior. And it looks really far from being done when you stand back here. But it's really like one tower. This tower right here is going to get duplicated right here. And then bring this wall over and then fill out the backside. And the exterior is done. So that's one thing that I was hoping to get towards here today. Not gonna finish that in this episode, but I wanted to do off-camera work so that maybe next time we can be closer and closer, and then bam, it'll be done. Just some of that off-camera grind that you guys have seen me do these. I need a window here. You guys have seen me build the exterior. It'll just be repeating myself on stuff that we've already done. And if you're new and you haven't seen me work on the exterior, I guess you'll have to go back. But anyways, this is another thing that I've been working on. And there's lots of stuff around that you probably might be noticing, maybe not. First thing is, I've been cleaning up a little bit. These ceilings have been really nasty, like right here. This is kind of nasty, right? So I've just been filling these in where they need to be filled in. This will all have to be redone. The nice thing about having so much room here is part of me wants to make this the floor of upstairs. Part of me is like, oh, I gotta make this work as a ceiling. But we've got so much room, I can make a whole new layer like that and just bring it all the way back, right? There's no reason I can't really do that. It might take some extra thinking, but I can do that. I'm not sure if that's what I want, so I'm just going to tear that down. Another thing, I brought this floor in, and it does go up a step. So that's a little bit interesting. This room, this will probably be a hallway, lots of bookcases, and maybe some chairs and stuff. Sort of like a lounging area, mostly decorative, and leading to other rooms back here. When I was building this in the first place, I was thinking, wow, this is a huge interior. How am I ever going to fill it? And then I started working on the main room, which is right here, the main entrance room, and I realized we've got most of it filled up. There's not going to be a whole lot of room after that. We might have to go down if we want more room. We can go back a little bit. I think that if we have, even if we only have rooms here and there, if everything's closed off, it'll give the impression that it's a lot bigger than it is. Because this isn't enormous. I had a suggestion a few episodes ago to make pillars right here. Like, bring a pillar down here, here. And I tried it, and it was just way too in the way. This room just isn't quite big enough for that. I didn't love it. But I knew that I wanted some sort of railing, so I made a railing like this. And I also put stairs here. Not sure how I'll tie this off right here. This is not a final decision. Even over here, I'm not really sure what's going to go here. So I'm just kind of working room by room, making sure that I'm not making it impossible. So I brought this floor out here, but I didn't make it impossible to use any space here. There's room for like three floors right here. Hallways, pretty much. And one of them will be a hallway that we'll have to lead. Oops, excuse me. Falling everywhere. One of them will have to be a hallway right here on this level going over to here, because otherwise we don't really have a way to get up there. And there will be something down there, and that can lead to the area. Now I actually want to be down there. That can lead to the area down there if we have rooms there. And then who knows what we're going to have up here. We have lots of room up here. I was thinking that these windows here could just be letting in light for this room right here. There's probably going to be a wall right here. I don't know how decorative we're going to want to get with it, though. And then when we do that, we have to keep in mind, what are we doing right here? What are we doing down here? You know, it's lots of doing stuff slowly and making sure that it's possible to work something out. As long as it's possible to work something out, then we'll be fine. If I don't leave myself any room, though, then we'll be in trouble. Honestly, though, we could have dead space in here, and if you guys didn't watch me build it, if you were just walking around it, a complete blind walkthrough, you probably wouldn't even notice that there was dead space somewhere. So, anyways, today's thing. Come up here, and this is not so much a throne room, because this isn't a castle, it's a guild hall. I want it to be sort of a meeting place, and this dirt, here's a rug, by the way, and these are the colors of our flag, right? I can't really see that right there. These are the colors. And then the dirt is outlining where a table's going to be, and that's what I'm going to work on right now. So what I'm going to need is some oak stairs and some slabs, and naturally I don't have any of them, so let's go make them. So how are you guys? I was pretty inactive this past week, or past few weeks, because I've just been busy, but I have a little bit more free time this next week, so expect a few episodes. I am pretty excited to get some work done here. What can we just throw away? Is there anything that I just simply do not want? Let's get rid of that. Let's get rid of it. Never see it again. I'm just going to make a pretty simple table here. I said that it's not going to be a throne room, but there is going to be somewhat of a fancy chair for whoever's in charge to sit in. So I need something. I don't know why I'm going about this in such a weird way. Let's corner this off that. And what I'm doing now is just making some legs for our table, like this, that. Let's see how that looks. I think it's getting dark in here. I'm not sure. We have to figure out lighting as well. I just have torches thrown around. Yeah, that's where I want it. Thanks. So let's get rid of that and step back. I don't want a completely square table. So let's say, is it getting dark? Not yet. Let's say you come in and you have some sort of matter that needs to be dealt with. So let's say this guy right there, his neighbor is making weird noises at night. And he doesn't, he can't sleep because he doesn't have a window there. He just has a fence in his window. So he can hear across. He can hear those weird noises that this guy is making at night. So he comes in here and he comes up here and there's some sort of committee here. And he says, "Sir, I have a complaint." And I listen to him and they work it out. And that is the types of things that farmers deal with, I think. I've got a chest here full of some stuff that I'm gonna need for one of my things. Okay, let's just throw stuff in here and grab all of it. I don't need all of it, but I do want to test some of it because I don't know for sure what way we're gonna go with it. Let's just put these where we can easily get them. If you'll notice, I am using colors from our flag. So let's go with the parts that I know that I need. Where's the center? Center is right here. That is a nice comfy seat. Have you ever seen those like leather seats with the buttons in the middle of them and they have like this pattern? That is exactly what that is for us right now. And you can even make it blue. I am not going to make it blue. There's our armchair. So what I'm wondering is, I want to do, let's just throw one down and then we'll do the other one and see which one we like more. Something like this. I kind of wish, is that the light gray or the gray? I'm not really sure. It'll just say banner if I hold it. No, yellow. How do you hit these things? Hello? There we go. Come here. It is light gray. I kind of wish I had a regular color. That matches the colors of the on the trapdoor, though, so that's all right. So what I'm going for here is some sort of tapestry on the chair, right? And then the back side of it is the other color from the flag. So I screwed that color up, apparently. So let's try the other one with the yellow tapestry. And we do have gray hardened clay here. And that's very bright, though. That's my only issue with that. Like, look at the yellow in the wall and the yellow in that. That is very bright. All right, I slept on it, and now I know what to do. I know what must be done. I also like that yellow because it's not nearly as bright. And it actually, that yellow matches this, too. So everything works out pretty good with that chair, I think. That's a pretty good chair, if I do say so myself. So kind of want some other chairs here, but I'm not sure where we want to put them. Let's grab some slabs, and we can fit one right here. Let's just push them up right against the table. We can do one. Can we put one like right in the corner? Is that a weird spot for a chair? That's probably a weird spot for a chair. I don't really care. And let's go ahead and make some trapdoors. That is a little theme here that I wanna keep. How many chairs did I just make? I think I need more than that. I've got enough now. So let's place all these. Our armchairs, we can just pretend that they're pushed in, and that's why this one's not pushed in. It just sits right here, and this is the view he gets. That's a pretty good view, if I do say so myself. I wouldn't mind having that view as I work, but I do not, so guess it sucks to be me. Let's put these down. I'm going to also take this moment to shamelessly plug. Guys, go follow me on Twitter. I have a lot of new subs, and Gosh, what the heck? I could have sworn I just grabbed more doors than that. I have a lot of subs, but new subs that have not followed me on Twitter. So go follow me on there. I'm not like a Twitter spammer or anything. So don't worry about that. I was thinking that. What is wrong with me? I just placed the doors. No wonder I couldn't find enough doors. I literally placed them and then. Forget that. I don't know what I'm doing. All right. So, yeah, that is our room here. I want to take a look at this real quick. What if I have an interesting idea here? Let's just make all those into oak wood. What if we brought this wall like this? And when we do this hallway, we can shove stuff in there like bookcases and whatnot, and maybe even have some nooks for sitting in. But this gives us the opportunity to bring some dimension into the meeting room. I wasn't sure what to call it. I guess we'll call it the meeting room. So let's see if we can't do that, because if we don't have something interesting going on with the walls, it's going to be pretty boring up there. So let's see how this looks. I do have plans. All right. Do we have any room? Okay, so we will have room to walk behind if we do something else. What if this simply got brought down? And could that look better if that was a different sort of pillar? I think it could look better as stone. Maybe. We do have quite a bit of stone going on in the rest of this room. We have some stone right there and our stairs. So let's do that. And we can even remove those. And then it might add a little something, a little bit of detail to the outside, because you're going to be able to see half of that. But this is the second floor of windows, the second tier, remember. So it's not going to be super, super noticeable. So it might be one of those things that, like, one of those details that if you notice it, you're like, wow, look at all the little things that you don't even notice here. Now this is cool. Now this gives me an idea right here. This is like little shelves. Have you ever seen a house that had like up high, like where you can barely reach? They have just like flat pieces of floor where the wall kind of goes in. Maybe there's a window that's set back into the wall, and then people have like plants sitting right there, right? That is exactly what I want to do with that. So let's go get some pots. I swear, I've been bone mealing all over this place and throwing away all of the flowers, and here I am trying to collect some of the flowers. I suppose I can just do this. Just go for it. Go for it. I don't want the yellow ones. Do I want the yellow ones? I guess I would go with... Ooh, is there a light gray flower? Or is it just going to be white that we can find? Oh, that was a waste of one. See those blue ones? Yeah, there's lots of white ones. Because that could... The gray could potentially fit our theme here with the yellow. Or rather, the white and the yellow could fit our theme. Am I picking up the yellows? What do I have here? Yeah, so I'll just keep them all for the moment. Maybe we want to mix up more than just the white and the yellow and make it look like more of an assorted random flowers, because we don't want it to look too organized either. I just grabbed a bunch of pots. Let's just throw them down. What the heck is this? Is that always going to be blue? Why is that blue? Is that like part of the texture pack? That's so ugly. Sorry. Oh, look at all these colors. I kind of like it now. Now that as the variety that I was talking about. This is azure. I'd rather have oxeye daisy. So let's just throw those in. Let's get some yellows and put a rose. Yeah, see, that's a little nice little detail. I also want a bunch of oak stairs to kind of taper off the bottom. Is that the right word? Taper off the bottom of these window ledges. How many do I need? A lot, I guess. Just to show you what I mean, right here, that's a pretty abrupt stop. Or rather, sharp curve, these 90 degree edges. And that helps round that out a whole lot. I'm going to get enough stairs and some sleep and then have that finished. Yeah, look at that. Now that is a pretty good wall right there. I do like that. I do indeed. However, I kind of want to take that other banner, that yellow one. I'm really bad at banner designs. I've never really messed with them. If we could throw in banners in the middle of all these sections, then that would be really cool. I'll probably have to come up with some kind of design and mess around with it. So that might be there for us next episode. And that will really make that wall complete, I think. Because the great thing about this wall is it's busy. It's got lots of... See, now look at this. These turned blue. They weren't blue in the first place. There's a purple one, so I'm not sure if that's... That doesn't look like it's supposed to be that color. I wonder what it looks like in default texture pack. Let's just try it out. See what it looks like. But yeah, the nice thing about this wall is it doesn't take away from the room, from the center being the focal point, but it does, however, wow, all this plain oak is like way too much in default texture pack. Maybe that's just me after playing in a texture pack, but I feel like if I were in default, then I'd be doing something to mix it up more. I'm not really sure, but it's not distracting you from anything, and at the same time, it still brings in a pretty high level of detail, and yeah, that's what I want to say. Anyways, guys, that's about it for this episode. I think this was a shorter episode since I did get a lot of it done before I started recording. I don't know, maybe you guys like that, having it so that I can just jump right into the discussion about it. I know some of you like to see me build stuff out at the same time. But, I just realized standing down here, you get a completely different feel of the entire place, it being so enclosed in. Let's go into creative really quick and get a overhead view. See, that is from up here. The roof looks really boring. That's fine. That's completely okay. Yeah, look how big this building is. It is pretty good. Go me. I'm so good at this game. So anyway, go back into... Hello, thank you. Zero, and bam. Still haven't finished this yet. I still gotta get more bookcases. I think I might have actually gotten bookcases earlier last week. Hello, frame rates? Earlier last week, just haven't placed them yet. So anyways, guys, thank you for watching. See you next time. Leave a like and subscribe. Bye.